cricket expert, Mr. Sabir Hussain. Assalamu alaikum, Sabir bhai.
Walaikum assalam.
How are you, sir?
Absolutely fine.
I've also been joined on Sports Extra tonight to talk on cricket, sports expert, Mr. Umar Khan. Umar, assalamu alaikum, welcome to Sports Extra.
Walaikum assalam. Thank you so much for having me.
Right, Sabir bhai, first of all, I think two ODIs have shown us that Pakistan team will live up to its expectation of being unpredictable. But I think it's been utterly disappointing. Third ODI is going to be played tomorrow in Birmingham, but if Pakistan win or lose, it doesn't really make a difference, because the fact is that a lot of things have been exposed.
Absolutely. I mean, most of the things are exposed, rightly said. Pakistan, you know, we have been talking about the middle order. Pakistan has been struggling, but I mean, Pakistan has to, you know, very quickly look after for its bowling department and as well as the batting department. Pakistani batting department is totally flopped. I mean, most of the fans are disappointed. Everybody was expecting that Pakistan have a great chance to win this series for the first time for more than two decades in England. But I mean, hats off to England. They regrouped, their team in a couple of hours before the series. I mean, but very, very, very rightly. But I mean, Pakistan, you know, struggling very bad time, because they have been touring England, I think, six times since 2016. Fakhar Zaman has toured already, Imamul Haq, Babar Azam, Mohammad Rizal, you just name it. I mean, even in the bowling department, Harris Rauf is struggling. If you talk about, you know, first one day of Pakistan, I mean, badly flopped as far as batting is concerned. 140 overs in less than 40 overs, not acceptable. And in the second ODI, Pakistan was supposed to chase, 240 is not a score on an England side, but Fakhar Zaman is struggling, 44 balls, 10 runs, not acceptable. Imamul Haq, basically, I think he has been struggling. He struggled in South Africa. I mean, also he's struggling in England as well. I mean, you have Abdullah Shafiq, but I don't think so. He will get a chance in third ODI. Mm-hmm. The third ODI will be played in Edgbaston, a very difficult condition for Pakistan in Birmingham, obviously. Cloudy weather, and the highest score on this ground is 408, again by England against Australia, and the lowest total defended by India, I think 127 against England. So I think difficult situation for Pakistan in bowling department, also in batting department.
Definitely, I'd buy that. There might be a difference in international cricket as well, but I think this argument that these players will remain in the mental block, then Sabir bhai, what is the job of a coach? Because to my understanding, the job of the coach is to eliminate this mental block.
Absolutely. You know, Mohammad Rizwan got out in the same situation. Imamul Haq basically struggling. He needs to focus. It's a psychological block, I think. It's basically individual's decision. I mean, obviously, Ms. Powell Huck's job is to, you know, to basically get out this mental block, the players. I mean, they have been in England for last 2 weeks. I mean, they have, you know, quarantine kind of system. Remember, they were in New Zealand and they just, I think, breached, I mean, COVID-19 rules, and they were, you know, further quarantined for a couple of more weeks. I mean, but here, I think, There is a psychological issue. Is individual's decision. They have to perform.
Sabir bhai, they had a chance to practice for 10 days.
10 days.
And Babar Azam kept on claiming that we've practiced for 10 days. We're used to the conditions by now.
They have been practicing with interest squad. I mean, you know, as far as the batting is concerned, Imamul Haq is obviously definitely struggling. Mohammad Rizwan, I think if Mohammad Rizwan is not performing, he has been phenomenal as far as the T20 is concerned. He has been phenomenal for last 2 years. But if he is struggling in ODIs, better to try Sow Shakil. Mm-hmm. Sow Shakil is a good youngster, left-hander. You know, he has been performing. So I think he should have, you know, batted up more than Rizwan, I think. He batted superbly in second ODI. He's a youngster. He stood the wicket. He played his
bowled well as well.
Obviously, he just accumulates his runs, I think. He's a good player. Mohammad Rizwan is not performing. I think Shadab Khan, why you are, you know, investing so much in Shadab Khan? You have a wonderful bowler, Mohammad Nawaz. He has performed in his batting as well as his bowling. So, I mean, Shadab Khan is playing. Why? Because he's vice-captain. I mean, Mohammad Nawaz has been performing in South Africa, in Zimbabwe as well, in ODIs. He's getting you wickets as well. If a bowler is not doing his job as far as bowling is concerned, there's no need for batting. I mean, look at his shot. I mean, short ball, he wanted to, you know, hit a six like a Sachin Tendulkar hit in Shoaib Akhtar in 2003 World Cup.
Definitely. I'll just... I'll